Hi, YouTube family. I just want to take a moment of your time. The picture you see above is my brother, my sister-in-law, and my nephew. My nephew passed away of lung cancer last year at 33 years old. Unfortunately, now we have another crisis in our family. My brother has been diagnosed with a rare cancer. I'm reaching out to my YouTube family for some support and some help. I'm trying to raise some money for my brother because his insurance keeps denying him. I want him to go to the best facility. We don't know much about this disease. It's gamma heavy chain. Never heard of it. It's only 200 people were diagnosed worldwide. It's so rare. There's not a lot of information on it. I'm going to share his GoFundMe in my description. If you please share it, I would appreciate it. Thank you. This is what my brother looks like now. He's lost so much weight. He's so sick and so weak. I am praying to God. I don't want to lose my brother. Please help and share this, please. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, my name is Janice. Today I have four cute Halloween DIYs that I want to share with you. This first DIY, I took this creepy picture that I got from Party City and the frame that I got from Five Below. And I'm using so many different colors because I'm trying to make the frame look very old and antique-ish. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the canvas from the frame. I'm not going to take the staples out because they're too hard. I'm just going to cut the back of it. So now that the staples are or the canvas is removed, I took four different colors, all different browns and a gray. And I'm just going to apply the paint with different colors, mixing them, trying to get like that, antique look type of frame. So this is what it looks like so far. That's not too bad. Kind of looks antique-ish. Now the frame is dry. I'm going to take the image and I'm going to apply it to the frame. I'm going to use this double-sided tape because I thought the hot glue probably would ruin it. So just to be safe, I'm just going to apply a little bit of the double-sided tape to the frame. So now I'm just lining it up, making sure it fits. Okay, it does appear to be a little bit too big for the frame, even though it's the same size. The top and the bottom portion of the way the image is, I didn't want to cut it because it has that hologram effect on it. So it's okay. It still looks good. I like it, and I think it came out pretty good. And this is what it looks like. It's such a cool image. I loved it when I seen it. And I'm gonna put it in my hallway. Look at the 2D, was it 3D effects, the way his face changes. It's so cute. I love it. Okay, so we are on the next DIY. I took this cauldron that I got from Party City. I was looking all over for one of these. Finally found one. And this sign that I got from Dollar Tree, I painted the back because I was going to use it for another project. And then the witch's legs that I got from Dollar Tree and these little witch's hats, all from Dollar Tree. Also got this baby from Dollar Tree. So I'm gonna take some floral foam that I got from Dollar Tree, and I'm gonna take my hot glue gun and put some glue inside the cauldron, and then place the foam inside there, and that's how I'm gonna apply the witch's legs. So I'm taking this metallic paint and I'm going to paint the outside of the cauldron and make it look like metal handles. I think it looks good just with one coat, with the black and the metal color. I think it looks fine. It brings out the, looks like real handles, and that's what I was going for. Now I'm going to be taking the witch's legs and I'm going to put them inside the cauldron with the foam and just push them one end to the other so it looks like their legs are separated and popping out. Now I'm going to be taking some tissue paper and just filling inside, making it look full because I don't want to use a lot of the polyester filler that I have. And plus the color is really great and it makes the light go through it even better. Now I'm taking some of this polyfiber fill and I'm just going to put some inside to make it look like it's bubbling water kind of effect. So I'm adding more and just trying to get that certain effect I'm looking for. So I have this sign that I got from Dollar Tree and I figured, well, let me put it in front with a little bit of hot glue. So I'm taking these Dollar Tree witch hats and start to apply it, and they kept falling off. And I didn't want to put hot glue because it was burning. It was going through it, the plastic. So I ended up taking it off. So now I'm going to take these Dollar Tree glow sticks that I got in the toy department. And then I'm going to shake them, snap them, and once they start glowing, I'm going to place them inside. It's hard to see it because the light's glaring on it, but can you see the glow, the green glow underneath? It's pretty cool. You'll see it once I shut the light. It'll shine better. So I'm taking some elephant gray and some black paint, and I'm going to take this Dollar Tree baby doll and just kind of like paint her up a little bit, trying to make it look like she got dirty from being inside the pot. Now I'm going to take the doll and just lay her inside the pot area, and it looks like she's hanging over trying to get out. So now I'm taking that little Dollar Tree sign that I had and I'm just going to spell out with my marker, "I smell children." So now I'm going to take my hot glue gun and just put a little bit of glue and put it on the side of it. I don't have the best handwriting. I should have used probably those little Dollar Tree stickers. Oh well. It'll do. And this is what it looks like so far. I think it's pretty cool. The baby doll looks, she's all dirty. Now I'm going to add some more of the little green lights and to make it a little more brighter. I think it's pretty cool. I think this is really cute for Halloween and it's really easy to do. And this is the final project. I think it came out really cute. Okay, moving on. This DIY, I took the Dollar Tree pumpkin and this canvas that I got from Five Below, and I'm taking two of the paints. I'm taking the black chalk paint and the elephant gray paint. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to paint the canvas black. Because this is a canvas material, it only takes one coat and it takes the black paint very well. So now the canvas is dry. I'm going to place the pumpkin on top and I'm going to cover the pumpkin in the elephant gray color. So I'm just dabbing the gray on top of the pumpkin. This is going to leave the outline of the pumpkin on the canvas, and that's what I'm going for. You can use this Dollar Tree pumpkin on wood or anything like that. You can use it for stain. You can use it in a variety of different ways. They even have leaves, I believe, at Dollar Tree as well. But I chose the pumpkin because I have an idea in mind that I seen that I wanted this particular canvas, and I think it came out awesome. So now I'm going to take the pumpkin off and I'm going to reveal what it looks like. I think it came out really great. I love it. So now I'm going to take the black paint and just touch it up around the pumpkin and just make it look cohesive. So now I'm going to take some Mod Podge and some gray glitter. And some black glitter, and I'm going to start to Mod Podge the gray area and then sprinkle the glitter all over it. Once it's fully coated with Mod Podge, I'm taking the silver glitter and I'm just going to start sprinkling it on top of the gray paint. So I'm going to have to wait for the Mod Podge to dry fully before I can start doing the black area with the glitter. So I'm just taking the glitter and just making sure there's enough on all the areas, putting a lot on it, and then I'm going to shake it off and see how it looks. So now the gray part is dry. I'm going to start Mod Podging the black area and start sprinkling the glitter all around the black surface of the canvas. So I'm doing little sections at a time, putting a little bit of Mod Podge and then sprinkling the glitter on top of that. and just doing little sections. This came out fantastic. I absolutely love this piece. You can, if you do replicate this, you can choose any type of color. I just picked the silver and the black. I just thought it was so beautiful. And this is how it turned out. It is such a pretty piece. I love the colors, the sparkle, with a light near my dining room or my living room. It's gorgeous. What do you think? Okay, last DIY. I took this Dollar Tree fence that I got last year and this little wood coffin I got from Michael's and the Dollar Tree skeletons and the heads I got from Dollar Tree, the bones I got from Party City, and this wood round I got from Dollar Tree and the moss from Dollar Tree. These are from Dollar Tree as well. Skeleton hand. Showing you that I cut one off, so I'm going to have to cut the other one. The spider web I got from Party City, and the rip sign I got from Dollar Tree. So the paint I'm going to be using is the black chalkboard paint, antique white from Apple Barrel, elephant gray paint from Apple Barrel. So I'm going to start off by using the black chalkboard paint on the wood round. So I'm going to take the little wood coffin and I'm going to start painting it with the elephant gray paint. And then I'm going to use a little bit of the black. And a little bit of the antique, not the antique, yeah, the antique white. And I'm just going to alternate back and forth until I get the look I'm looking for. With the mixture of colors, it's starting to look pretty good. That's the look I was looking for. Distressed, old, creepy. So here's what it looks like. I think it came out really nice and not nice, but creepy and spooky. Now I'm taking the skeleton hands, and because they're so bright white, I'm going to take some gray paint, some black paint, and just paint over the hands. Now, I'm taking one of these little Dollar Tree skeleton heads and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put a little bit of gray, a bit of antique white, and a little bit of black. So I'm just taking some of the gray, white, and black paint and just going over the skeletons with them. There's three skeletons that I'm going to be using. Now I'm taking this Dollar Tree rip sign, little wood sign, and I'm going to start painting it. I use black marker to outline the outside area of it. So now I'm going to take the gray paint and just go over it. The round wood and this fence that I got from Dollar Tree, and I'm going to take some fix-all glue from Dollar Tree, and I'm going to be using my hot glue gun to attach the fence to the wood. First thing I'm going to do is apply the fix-all, and then I'm going to apply the hot glue. So I have to hold the wood piece with the fence so the hot glue can dry and it can hold it together. So I cut out these skeletons from a fence from a Halloween fence from Dollar Tree, and I'm just going to hot glue them to this fence. So my hot glue gun, and I'm attaching the skeletons to the fence. Now I'm taking the little coffin box, and I had some leftover scarf from Dollar Tree, and I cut a little piece out, and I'm just going to hot glue it inside. So I'm just cutting off the excess pieces and making sure it fits inside. I'm taking the skeleton and I'm placing him inside the coffin, trying to figure out how I want to situate him. I put a little hot glue on the back of him and placing him inside. I'm taking the rip sign and a piece of black material I have, and I'm going to hot glue it to the back of the sign and then cut off the edges. And here's what the rip sign looks like. It's pretty cool. Now I'm taking some of the moss and I'm going to start placing it down. I have green reindeer moss, I think it's called, and I'm going to mix a little bit of each, and then I'm going to hot glue it down. I'm trying to make it look like a grave site where it has like a little bit of the dark burnt grass and a little bit of bright grass. Now I'm taking the skeleton hands and I'm going to hot glue them down, and also the little skulls, I'm going to hot glue them down as well. I'm placing down the skeletons on the fence. One, I put like he's laying down, and it's so funny. Then I'm going to put the other one on the other side of the fence. placing down the casket right in the middle of the area. And then I took these pipe cleaners and I'm trying to make a tree out of it so I can hot glue it inside. So I'm going to be using these black flowers I got from Dollar Tree and just taking the little eyeballs out, and I'm going to hot glue them to the pipe cleaner tree that I'm making. So I'm taking these bones that I got from Dollar Tree. They're like foam material. And I'm just going to hot glue a few to the tree and a few inside the graveyard area. So I'm taking one of these white skull rings that I got from Dollar Tree. I'm just going to cut the ring part off and I'm going to hot glue it to the tree that I made. The lights that I got from Dollar Tree, and I'm going to string it all around the outside of the round wood area. And a little bit of hot glue towards the back of the area just so it holds in place. It came out really cool, the lights on. It's so awesome. So I'm adding a few bones and on the front area and inside, just laying them around, just trying to find areas to place it. Now I'm taking some of this spider web, white spider web, and I'm just going to place it around inside, around the skeletons. It comes with the spiders, and I placed one hanging off the tree on the spider web. It's pretty cool. Well, it looks like it's finally finished, and I think it really came out spooky and awesome. And this is the final product. What do you guys think? Well, that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I do appreciate it. Until next time, guys, bye-bye.